The cardiac cycles run by cardiac muscle cells, namely myocardial conducting cells send signals electrically. Nodal tissues make action potentials through self-excitation. Conduction fibers send these to other cells to start their action. The heart's physiological pacemaker, the SA node C, its impulses are conducted to cardiomyocytes. Whee! Cardiomyocyte intercalated disav gap junctions, which gives ionic continuity for synchronized contractions. Under a fat pad, the SA node in the right atrium hides. In the subepicardiac layer, the SA node resides. It features cardiac pacemaker cells with transition cells on its sides. P cells contain cholinergic and adrenergic receptors, which respond to autonomic ganglion neurotransmitters. Through the right atrium, internodal conduction pathways go. These three branches connect SA node and AV node, so you know. These conduction pathways transmit action potentials rapidly, so they can go from the SA node to the AV node quickly. The AV node is the secondary pacemaker of the heart. This smaller node of the interatrial septum is a part. It's in the subendocardiac layer in Koch's triangle. Conducts electrical signals from SA node to ventricle. The AV node's the one path to ventricles. APs cross it must, since atrioventricular septum cartilage can't conduct. Autonomic ganglion cells surround the AV node, but they don't synapse with the AV node, unlike the SA node, okay. The AV node has less B cells, but more transition cells, got it. It passes through the fibrous cardiac skeleton, and this bit is the start of the AV bundle, known as the bundle of his, that's lit. The bundle of his goes through the fibrous trigone and into the membranous part of the interventricular septum, oh yeah. Importantly, it only lets action potentials go forward. No retrograde transmission can occur, it only goes forward. From membranous to muscular interventricular septum, bundle bifurcates, now left and right bundle branches it becomes. The left at muscular interventricular septum starts next. It trifurcates to these divisions on approach to the apex. Posterior septal anterior go to papillary muscles, interventricular septum, and also left ventricle walls. The right branch past membranous interventricular septum runs, remember, to the right of the interventricular septum. It branches to ventricular walls, then to the apex proceeds through septomarginal band, then to papillary muscles lead. The left and right bundles have subendocardiac branches, and these Purkinje fibers are found along their full length. Understand, these go to the apex, then up and back through the ventricle walls extend. Purkinje fibers have many gap junctions for fast signaling. Thus more ions pass from one cell to the next for faster conducting. Faster than ventricular muscles and AV nodal fibers, and there's little to no contraction due to few myofibrils. Fast bundle transmission through the ventricles makes up for delay, so ventricles contract shortly after the atria, hooray! The main branches of the AV bundle are insulated, so early excitation of nearby cardiac tissues block yo. Depolarization starts with papillary muscle, then goes to the ventricle apex, and finally to the walls it flows. No, the ANS has an effect on cardiac conduction. Cardiac plexus tissue gives sympathetic stimulation. Parasympathetic influence comes from cranial nerve 10. There's less excitability at SA and AV nodes then. The sympathetic nervous system gets epinephrine released to bind receptors in SA and AV nodes, causing increased SA node depolarization rate, so now the heart rate gets increased. Cardiomyocytes receive sympathetic signals also. They increase inotropy, and now cardiac output will grow. Parasympathetic activation at SA and AV nodes results in reduced cardiac input, and now this is key. It slows SA node activation, dampens contractility of cardiomyocytes, reduced cardiac output we see.
The diagrams in this video were from KenHub, a platform for learning human anatomy, histology, and medical imaging. KenHub combines multiple learning tools to make studying easy and fun. Their content is organized into study units, combining multiple learning methods to help you master each topic. Make sure to take advantage of this 10% discount link. A premium subscription gives access to superb videos and quizzes. Videos have speed controls, closed captions, and transcripts. There are several types of quizzes based on difficulty, as well as custom quizzes. KenHub also offers muscle anatomy reference charts, which are free for premium users, but can be purchased independently.